you do. Halfway through day one, doors are off, started to strip down, steering columns out, and it's been shipped out to light steer. Paint's proving to be a bit tricky to get off at the moment, so we'll see how that goes. Started welding in the roof now. Thomas has already made quite a lot of progress on the seats. Seat frames needed a bit of repair, so we've done that, and all the glasses don't look like a back glass at all, to be honest. It's just it's paint now, that's the concern.
So welcome to the second episode of the Split Week Challenge. We're actually still on day one. We're in the afternoon of day one, but the bus has been stripped down and we're in the workshop ready to start on the bodywork. In this video, there is a lot of bangs and a lot of noise because there's a lot of bodywork, a lot of hammers and a lot of grinders going today. So apologies if you're wearing headphones because, yeah, there's a lot of hammers and a lot of grinders. How was that? Hopefully that wasn't too bad. So in the first episode, the guys were using the pressure washer to try and get the roller paint off of the bodywork. And in some areas that worked really well, in others it didn't so much. So there's four or so different layers of paint on this. You can see the original paint there, then a primer, then a brown color, and maybe even a red looking at it there. And then finally, a thick layer of white paint which looks like it was put on with a roller. So that was coming off with a pressure washer in some places, and in other places it was on pretty well. So yeah, the wet sanding now is slowly breaking through those layers, but it is taking a really long time. You know, we've only got 6 days to do this, and at this rate it could take that amount of time wet sanding to get through all those layers of paint. But it is great to see that original paint. And there may be light at the end of the tunnel.
There is a lot of bare metal though as well being exposed, which isn't great news.
A few bits of bare metal will be fine, but if there's too much bare metal, then it's not gonna work. You can see there, it goes from the brown color to perhaps the red, and then it's straight into bare metal. In fact, there's almost like a peachy color there as well, looking at that. Power ballads are on.
Boom. I was going to say the power ballads are on, so you have to listen to the team singing. Hope you enjoy that. Turns out that hole was actually pretty useful in the end. So the guys here are trying to attack the paint with a scraper, which is working to a certain extent. As you can see here, it's taking off the white paint, but I mean, that's just one layer. There's another two or three layers below that.
When it starts to smell, mate, I couldn't work anymore, you know?
The original red paint we got.
Flatten off the whole fucking body, blown a lot over in grey primer, blown a lot over in colour, and we can rub its back to go along, make it look patina. It's fake patina, but it's 6 days and that ain't gonna cut it. It's not original paint, is it? And it's half of it's all gone, so.
I like that.
Huh?
I like that.
On your own. Now we are still gonna rub it back, get some bits through. Yeah, let's dig out all these fucking sills then and get the edges nice.
What a job is Brock.
So we took a gamble, it's not paid off. What we're gonna have to do now is get it back to as close to bare metal as possible, primer it, put the colour on, fake patina, and then obviously get the side writing done. It's unfortunate the original paint's not there, but we were to know, no one was, so that is now the plan. So, front clip's coming off, all the edges are getting sorted now, we'll get everyone on DAs and let's get back. So, trying to get it all back to its original paint, but it does look like it's been rubbed out unfortunately. Sucks, but what can you do? We want to know what was under the paint. So, we're going to go for a false patina now. Watch this space.
So with the realisation the paint isn't going to work going back to original paint, there just isn't enough original paint there. A spot of lunch, some good tunes, the guys are all on it, attacking the bus to get rid of all that silicone which has been holding in the doors and the glass all over the bus for many years. Also to get rid of some old seals. Clean up all those areas, ready for the new glass and for the next. So today is a loud one, it's lots of banging, it's grinders, it's hammering panels. So yeah, hopefully it's not too bad on your ears. Some parts are coming off quite well with the scrapers, others are incredibly difficult to get off. You know, what should be potentially a very quick job turns into a much longer job because it's been siliconed in for so long. Whatever they use was good stuff though, it's very tough. Finally, one that's not siliconed in and is actually easy to get out. That's more like it. If only all the others were like that. There we go. So this is the split week challenge. It is a 6 day build on a barn find bus, a 1966 Volkswagen split screen.
What a job is Brock.
So I pulled this engine out of a beach buggy. So we pulled this engine out of a beach buggy, unknown as a part X on some work. Part X on some work. So yeah, just making this wire for the choke and fuel cut off, so we'll see how it goes.
right. Got our little bench tester here.
Ignition light.
That's right. fuel. Oh, you put on. Done was put an alternator belt on, bit of easy start and a fuel line, made the pipe, and that's it. Then I got no history on the motor, so better change the oil now.
What a job is rock.
The guys are still at it hard to get all those seals clean, get all that sealant off.
Dean, is this for it? You gonna take this front clip off? Slay this girl off.
No, we're just gonna silicone it back in.
Come on. What's need this?
So if you saw the first episode, you would have seen that the front clip is spot welded in places and then silicone. So the silicone is now out, but the spot welds are holding on pretty well. Fairly messy day today, tearing down and breaking up the van, ready for the bodywork.
Thank you.
an appropriate song? I'm not so sure.
Close that black line like that, though.
Yeah, come off, yeah.
You should split apart.
Lands on the back of that, how's one going? Close, isn't it?
So if you didn't catch that, the front panel there is connected and you need to grind down the side to be able to remove it. So there we go, you can see they've grinded the edge, so now those panels are separated. I'd say today's a loud one, there's lots of grinders and hammers. Towards the end of the week, when the interior's going in and they're just placing things back together, it'll be a bit more peaceful. But yeah, noisy couple of days in the workshop at the moment, that's for sure. Yeah, the dash had a big hole cut out of it, so we've got a piece here to go back in to sort that out. And it needs to get painted as well. Slowly getting there. This is pretty much it for the whole day, just guys working on different sections of the vans, just tearing it down, getting it ready to build it back up. SDS, making good progress on the interior. Process to get these panels off, but the good news is underneath the bus is looking pretty straight so far, no major surprises. It's a good vehicle to actually use as a base to build. Still got to clean up some areas, but it doesn't look like there's going to be any major surprises, so that's great news. It's a real shame about that paintwork. Ah, the grinders have ended. Peace at last. Into the evening, into the night shift. Ah, spoke too soon. Grinders are back out.
Transmission jack from over there, put it under the gearbox, undo that, and then gearbox will be out.
Nice.
So gearbox and beam are coming out tonight.
Can we get a transmission jack under the front, just in case the weight. Okay. No, if you take this out, I don't want the van to shift.
What a job. Who is Brock?
Few ciders and a bit of food. Little pit stop, ready to keep on cracking on with the late shift. Need to get that beam and gearbox out. With 6 days only on this build, there are lots of jobs which have to be done specific times in order to be able to progress with the next work that needs doing.
Spence before.
Pulling it.
What's new?
If isn't all.
Yes. F***ing
off. Of course it's f***ing off. What do you think this thing to say?
Shut up your face. What if it was you free?
What are you doing?
What's Stein doing that? He's gonna be turning it, it's probably already off.
Coming up, mate, hold on.
What's that?
This seriously this nut. Yeah, it just seems to just be turning and turning.
That's it.
Oh, that's why it's turning and turning.
Ready.
That's it. What's up? Stand there and watch me burn.
Is there a voice on that?
But just who is Brock? Where did he come from? It is a strange story that begins many years ago.
Next time on the Split Week Challenge. More grinding! Oh dear. But also panels are going back on. Next video coming very soon. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that thumbs up if you've enjoyed the video and subscribe so you can catch the next one. Live workshop streams are happening every day over on Facebook. See you on the next one.